Good morning, children. In the last class, we discussed about properties of rational numbers. That is, properties of addition of rational numbers and properties of subtraction of rational numbers. And we need to prove these same properties for multiplication and division. Today, we are going to discuss these properties for multiplication, which was our first property, closure property. And we need to prove this closure property is applicable for multiplication of rational numbers. We are going to check. So, multiplication. Multiplication and our first property, closure property. Closure property. We know closure property of subtraction of rational numbers and addition of rational numbers. We have two rational numbers A and B. Then if A and B are two rational numbers, A plus B is another rational number and A minus B is also another rational number. So, we need to check if you are multiplying two rational numbers, their product is a rational number or not. So, I am taking two rational numbers, A equal to 1 by 3 and B equal to 3 by 2, two different rational numbers, and we need to check A into B is a rational number or not. Then A into B equal to 1 by 3 into 3 by 2. Here we need to multiply the numerators, 1 into 3 by 3 into 2, it is 3 by 6. Is it a rational number 3 by 6? Yes, 3 by 6 is another rational number. And 3 by 6 we can reduce it into 1 by 2. 3 by 6 is equal to 1 by 2. It is the least form because 3 into 1 is 1 into 3 is 3 and 2 into 3. 3 is the common factor. So, we remove that common factor. So, 3 by 6 become 1 by 2. So, 1 by 3 is a rational number and 3 by 2 is another rational number and their product 1 by 2 or 3 by 6. They are also a rational number. Then second property, commutative property. Commutative property. What is commutative property of addition? If we have two rational numbers A and B, we can add these two numbers in any order. That means A plus B is equal to B plus A. And this commutative property is not hold for subtraction of rational numbers. That is, A minus B is not equal to B minus A. And we need to check for multiplication, is it equal or not equal? That is, A into B is equal to B into A, or A into B is not equal to B into A. Okay, so we need to take some rational numbers, two rational numbers. We are going to take any two rational numbers. Suppose A equal to 1 by 3 and B equal to 5 by 2. Then first we are multiplying A into B. What is A into B? A into B is equal to 1 by 3 into 5 by 2, which is equal to 5 by 6. Next we need to check what is B into A. B into A is equal to 5 by 2 into 1 by 3, that is 5 by 6. which means A into B is equal to B into A. So we can say that if A and B are two rational numbers, then A into B is equal to B into A. That is commutative property of multiplication. Then third property. Do you know which is the third property? Yes, it is associative property. Third one, associative property. Associative property. To prove this associative property, we needed three rational numbers, that is A, B, C. Then if A, B and C are three rational numbers, then for addition we can say that A plus B plus C is equal to A plus B plus C. And for subtraction, it is not hold for subtraction, that is A minus B minus C, which is not equal to A minus B minus C. Okay, and we need to check, is it satisfied for associative property multiplication? What about multiplication? To prove this associative property, we needed how many rational numbers are needed to prove this associative property? We needed three rational numbers. Suppose A, B and C are the three rational numbers. Then what is associative property of addition? We can add these three rational numbers in any order. That is A plus B. Here first we are adding first two numbers plus third number, which is equal to A plus B plus C. Okay, and what about the subtraction? A minus B minus C, is it equal? No, it is not equal to A minus B minus C. And we need to check, is it applicable for multiplication? So we can take three rational numbers. That is associative property of multiplication means A into B into C equal to or not equal to. We don't know is it equal to or not equal to. We need to check. We need to prove. We already studied associative property of multiplication of integers. For integers, it is equal. So we need to check. Is it needed to check? We can say that they are equal. We already studied we can multiply any numbers, any integers in any order. Same way we can multiply three rational numbers also in any order. Anyway, we can check is it applicable or not. We can take any two rational numbers. Suppose A equal to 1 by 2, B equal to 1 by 3 and C equal to 1 by 5. Three rational numbers. So, first A into B into C. Here first we are multiplying A into B. Then A is 1 by 2 into B is 1 by 3. Into C, that is 1 by 5. 1 by 2 into 1 by 3 is 1 by 6 into 1 by 5. 1 into 1, 1, 6 into 5, 30. Then we need to check A into B, A into B into C. That is, here we are multiplying the last two, that is B into C at first. What is inside the bracket that we solve at first? Equal to. What is A? A is 1/2. 1/2 into bracket, then 1/3 into 1/5 equal to 1/2 into 1/3 into 1/5. That is 1/3 into 5, 15 equal to 1/30. Here A into B into C, which is equal to 1/30, which means what is the difference? Here first we are multiplying the first two rational numbers. There we multiplied the last two numbers at first, but our answer here 1/30, here also our answer is 1/30. So we can conclude that A into B into C is equal to A into B into C. If A, B and C are three rational numbers, then A into B into C equal to A into B into C. That is associative property. Then next property, fourth property, multiplicative identity. We discussed additive identity. Which is our additive identity? Additive identity means if we are adding a number to any rational number, we need to get the same rational number as our result. Suppose 2/3, it is a rational number, plus another rational number. We are adding a rational number, any rational number to this 2/3, we need to get 2/3 as the result. Then which number we added here? Here we added 0. When we are adding 0 to 2/3, we are getting 2/3 itself. So we can say that 0 is the additive identity. Next we are going to discuss multiplicative identity. That means 2/3 into a number is equal to 2/3 itself. Which is that number? Which number we need to multiply 2/3 to get 2/3 itself? I think all of you got that answer. Which is that number? 1. 2/3 into 1 equal to 2/3. If you are multiplying 1 with any number, we will get that number itself. And any number, 2/5 into 1 equal to 2/5. This we already studied. If you are multiplying 1 with any number, we will get that number itself. So we can say that 1 is the multiplicative identity. 0 is the additive identity and 1 is the multiplicative identity. Multiplicative identity, that is 1 is the multiplicative identity. Next, next property, multiplicative inverse. Next property, that is fifth property, zero property. Zero property means 2/3 into 0. What is 2/3 into 0? 2/3 into 0 is 0 itself. That also we already know. When we are multiplying 0 with any number, our product will be 0. Always the product will be 0. That is 2 into 0, 0. Okay, if we are multiplying 0 with any number, our product will be 0 itself. So that is 0 property. If we are taking any rational number A, a into 0 equal to 0 or 0 into a also equal to 0. That is zero property. And here we are going to discuss one more property. That property we didn't discuss for addition and subtraction. That property is distributive property. Distributive property. Then first, distributive property of multiplication over addition, and we need to discuss this distributive property for subtraction also. So distributive property means that is combination of addition and multiplication. We need three rational numbers A, B, C. We need three rational numbers, and the A into B plus C is a distributive property of multiplication over addition, which is first one, that is A into B. We are distributing this A to B, then plus, then A into C. This is distributive property of addition. A into B plus C is equal to, first we multiplied this A with B, plus A into C. Then what about the distributive property of multiplication over subtraction? A into B minus C equal to A into B minus A into C. So for distributive property we have two conditions. If it is addition, A into B plus A into C. Subtraction means here it is the change. If it is addition, it will be plus. If it is subtraction, this will be minus. That only the change. Here A into B, here also A into B. That means A into this first number plus A into second number. Then A into B minus A into C. Okay. So that is properties of multiplication of rational numbers, and we can discuss that all properties once again. Our first property, which was our first property, closure property. Closure property. For this we need two rational numbers A and B. If A, B are two rational numbers, then A into B is another rational number. So if you are multiplying two rational numbers, our product is also a rational number. A into B is rational number. Then second property, commutative property means we can multiply any rational numbers in any order. That is A into B equal to B into A. Then associative property, associative property. Three rational numbers are needed, A, B and C. Then A into B into C equal to A into B into C. Then multiplicative identity. Which is the multiplicative identity? 1. Then fifth one, zero property means if you are multiplying 0 with any number, A into 0 equal to 0 into A. Then last one, distributive property. Distributive property. Here we have two cases for addition and subtraction. That is A into B plus C equal to A into B plus A into C. And A into B minus C is equal to A into B minus A into C. These are the six properties. These are the six properties of multiplication of rational numbers. I think these all are clear. These five, six properties are clear. That's all for today. Thank you.